Now to Asia, where there is a new push from the Malaysian Prime Minister to go to the gold standard. Now, at a conference in Tokyo, Mahathir Mohamad said East Asia should use a common currency backed by gold. Now, this would be a part of an effort to cut ties from the U.S. dollar. Now, Malaysia would not be the first country to look for less reliance on the dollar. And we've reported in the past that Russia and Turkey have also questioned their use of the U.S. dollar. So to learn more, we turn to investigative journalist Ben Swan. Thank you for joining us on this, Ben.
Scotty, thanks for having me on.
Because when I think of the gold standard, I think of Ben Swan, of course. And so I had to bring you in on this subject, like that little intro there. Why is, however, Malaysia looking to return to the gold standard? And what is the benefit of this?
Well, the benefit is that you, first of all, reduce your reliance on the U.S. dollar, which is pegged to nothing, really, other than oil. And it's not truly pegged to oil, but because oil is traded only in dollars, we kind of have what we call a petrodollar, certainly more than we have a gold standard. We don't have a gold standard. The U.S. dollar is being printed on a regular basis. We all know that. The Federal Reserve goes nuts and prints money anytime they need it. It overall devalues our currency, and it devalues the currency of everybody else who's holding dollars. The problem with this idea, Scotty, and I'll give you a little history lesson, is that this is not, as you mentioned, the first time that a leader has suggested this. But I will ask you a question. The last leader who actually proposed removing the U.S. dollar as the standard currency and instead moving to a fully gold-backed currency across an entire continent was Muammar Gaddafi.
See how well that worked out for him.
Right. He suggested doing that as a way of trading oil, that all African nations would use gold, which he had, by the way, stockpiled a massive amount of gold in Libya. They would use gold in order to remove the dependency on the U.S. dollar. And we all know what happened to him. So in this case, I don't think Malaysia is going to have a whole lot of luck moving in this direction, though they don't have near as much pull as a Libya would as a member of OPEC.
Okay, well, that's what's so interesting about this. Is this easier just to say this kind of like a campaign promise than actually doing it? And what are some of those hurdles if a country, whether it's Malaysia or any other country, including the United States, wanted to actually make their currency be backed by gold?
Right. So obviously there's a tremendous number of issues with it. One of the issues is you need to have a tremendous amount of gold stockpiled in order to make this work. There are very few countries that actually have the kind of stockpile that you would need to pull this off. As I mentioned, Libya was, is not anymore, but was one of those countries that had spent a lot of time and resource stockpiling gold. Because if you're going to have a gold standard, you have to have enough gold that you have enough currency to be able to stay afloat. So Libya was able to do that. China has a massive amount of gold stored up in their country, but most countries do not. Now, I do not know, I'll confess, I do not know what Malaysia's gold holdings look like. But I will say this, whether you want to move that direction or not, the bottom line is, think about what you're actually saying. You're saying, as a country, we're going to move away from the U.S. dollar. And the U.S. empire, the United States of America, has no interest in allowing other countries, either as individuals or to create a movement that moves away from dependency on that dollar, and will do whatever is necessary to keep the rest of the world dependent on it.
Well, it's interesting because this is an economic question that kind of goes over into history. I mean, the U.S. took themselves basically off the gold standard since 1933. As you point out, we are just kind of printing money here in the U.S. If the rest of the global economy is basing itself off of us, yet we don't have gold backing up our own dollars, isn't this sort of unrealistic to think that we could actually, is this more of a political move rather than an economic to get not only away from the U.S., but to also make sure that they're just talking to the people where they're not actually making any real deals that make sense?
Yeah, I think it absolutely is more of a political move than an economic move. And you're right, since 1933, the U.S. has not been on the gold standard, but we officially left the gold standard, ended it in 1971. What's interesting about that is it took a little over 1 year for the U.S. to realize that the U.S. dollar had to be pegged to something, and then made a deal with Saudi Arabia for all oil to be traded. That's why I referred to it as a petrodollar earlier, because we needed something to peg it to. And so when you talk about this, again, any country, whether it be a Libya or it be a Malaysia or a China, any country that says we want to reduce dependency on the U.S. dollar, I think a lot of countries are moving in that direction. But how do you legitimately do that? Because one of the things the U.S. has done a very good job of in the last couple of years is trying to do what China has done in the past of making loans to other countries for infrastructure and for building out their countries so that there is a dependency on the U.S. and on the U.S. dollar and the U.S. Treasury when they have to repay those loans. So the U.S. is doing a good job of getting out there and getting the U.S. dollar into as many places as possible, knowing there is a resistance movement that is growing.
Well, thank you so much for bringing us in. I know this is just the very beginning of it, and then you bring in cryptocurrencies and all other sort of issues that bring into this and make it a very interesting thing to look at, regardless of what country that you are in. Thank you so much for Ben for joining us.
Hey, YouTube, thanks for checking out our channel. We hope you enjoyed the video. We have tons of content for you just like this. For more of RT America's one-of-a-kind news and analysis, be sure to subscribe and never stop questioning more.